You're watching a crewed rocket take off from US soil for the first time in almost 10 years in a commercial spaceship built by SpaceX. This is a huge deal because in the past decade, all we've seen from the US is stuff like this. Cargo missions, experiments, and test launches, some of which have failed. But now there are two human people on board, headed for the International Space Station, which hasn't happened since 2011, when NASA shut down the space shuttle program. Since then, China and Russia have been the only two countries on Earth with the ability to launch humans into space. So why did it take so long to send Americans back to space from America? And why are we doing it right now? On July 21st, 2011, the space shuttle Atlantis touched down at Kennedy Shuttle Landing Facility for the final time. After 30 years, NASA was ending its space shuttle program. But it was never supposed to last that long anyways. The space shuttle was originally proposed as a 15-year program to develop a reusable and low-cost way to get to space, mainly to haul up the materials needed to build the International Space Station, and then once it was built, the people needed to run it. The space station is a football field-sized research station in low Earth orbit, invaluable not only for learning about space itself, but also for experimenting in microgravity, which can't be recreated on Earth. And the space station was successfully built, but the shuttle never quite lived up to its low-cost promise. Early estimates in 1973 put the cost per flight at $9.3 million, but by the end of its run, the numbers added up to $1.5 billion per mission. And the program also cost lives. Shuttles were destroyed in flight during the 1986 Challenger and 2003 Columbia disasters, killing all seven astronauts on board in both instances. Coupled with rising costs, it was clear the program needed to end. But NASA didn't want out of the human spaceflight game altogether, because if we're going to go beyond the moon, well, we need more information.
One thing the space station helps us understand is what happens to the human body in space. This is a huge area of research we need to understand before we start talking about sending people to the moon and staying there. If we don't do that research or as much of it, then we're not doing due diligence that we need before we start sending people to these far-off destinations in deep space.
The plan was to come back in 4 years with a new program, Constellation. The program's goals were to complete construction of the space station, go back to the moon by 2020, and eventually send astronauts to Mars. And with all that, NASA would develop a new transportation system.
Plan B is, okay, we'll move over to the Russians, we'll pay them for seats to launch our astronauts, and that's what we're going to be doing for the next 4 years.
That didn't quite pan out. When former President Barack Obama took office in 2008, his administration declared Constellation over budget, behind schedule, and lacking in innovation. It was not included in the federal budget for 2011 and officially canceled. In Russia, those trips can cost more than $90 million per seat. So, on to Plan C, the Commercial Crew Program. NASA invests upfront in other companies to develop rockets. And once a rocket is completed, NASA pays per use, which on a SpaceX rocket costs about $55 million per seat, less than one trip on a Russian rocket.
This is a competition. If you can achieve these goals, we'll give you more money. And if you can achieve those goals, we'll give you even more money, to the point where you can launch our astronauts on test missions and we'll eventually pay you for tickets on your commercial spacecraft.
And what you're looking at now is SpaceX getting there first. SpaceX went through years of designing, testing, and failing, and finally, in 2020, the company was ready to get veteran astronauts Robert Behnken and Douglas Hurley off the ground.
It's been an incredible journey for SpaceX, but it hasn't been an easy one. They've had failure after failure. In fact, Gwynne Shotwell, the president and COO of SpaceX, told Business Insider, "This is how we got here. We made these mistakes, we learned from them, and because of that, we're able to do the really hard thing, which is put a crew on top of a rocket and try to launch them into space. We're going to be confident about that because of the mistakes we've made in the past."
Commercial crew vehicles have to be able to safely fly and return four crew members to the space station, remain docked at the station for 210 days, and protect the crew and bring them back to Earth in case of emergency. And this is the Falcon 9 Crew Dragon's final major milestone before it's cleared for operational crewed missions. But a successful launch does not mean a successful test. We won't be able to make that call until Behnken and Hurley are back on Earth, and they could stay up there for 110 days.
This is about America's access to space. If SpaceX can show that it, hand in hand with NASA, can launch people safely into space, then it opens up this huge commercial market for space, and one that is distinctly an American commercial market.
That's why this launch was deemed essential, even during a pandemic.
We want to see private space stations. We want to see private experiments launched into space, pharmaceutical drugs developed there, new materials developed there. We want to see all this activity. So it's crucial that we get it going sooner versus later.
Both astronauts have been quarantined since May 13, but this is protocol for every mission. What's changed because of the COVID-19 pandemic is this. The launch was closed to the public, and hundreds of SpaceX and NASA employees worked in shifts and wore the necessary PPE to minimize exposure. Despite the risks, both pandemic-related and inherent, NASA appears to be confident that this test will be a success. It's already announced SpaceX's first operational launch, tentatively set for August 2020, flying 4 astronauts, 3 American and 1 Japanese, to the space station for a 6-month mission, and more missions are planned after that.
It's not just about human spaceflight and spiking the football for the United States. It's about a new generation of commercial activity in space, a new generation of commercial providers, and blowing the doors off this really exciting, bold future, and not just for America, but for the entire world.